Salisbury, Engeland. Een keurig aangehaakt dorpje waar de former Secretary of State of Great Britain een enorm landgoed bezit. Dat is ons reisdoel. Maar hoe zijn we hier verzeild geraakt? In 1976 was de televisie voor het eerst bij Pinkpop en headliner dat jaar was URIAH HEEP. Eén fragment bleef bewaard, een versie van Sweet Lorraine. Het nummer staat op YouTube. Eronder commentaar van fans die suggereren dat de zanger David Byron stomdronken was. En dat wordt bevestigd door amateurbeelden waarin hij te zien is, zwaaiend met een fles op het podium.
Take me across the water, cause I need some place to hide. I've done the ranch of Dota, and I sure did hurt.
Het landgoed woont de manager van URIAH HEEP en daar is vandaag ook gitarist Mick Box, het enige overgebleven oorspronkelijke lid van de nog steeds actieve band. We hebben een verrassing voor hem. 30 minuten van de verloren gewaande opname van Pinkpop.
Let's have your hands together. You got rock and roll. You got URIAH HEEP.
Was a 24/7 character, charisma. He had everything, you know. And he never let, you know, most people like, you know, go on stage, you have an ego to be on stage because you're getting up to play and show off and do what you do. And then I come off stage and I'm just Joe Ordinary, you know, Mr. Ordinary. But David could never be that. He was a showman off stage, on stage, when he was cleaning his teeth, when he was going out of the night, when he was driving a car, he was just full on. David did have a drink before he went on stage, that's for sure. But, you know, having seen the footage, you can't do a backflip like that from being on the ground and backflip up if you're drunk. You know, especially on those high platform shoes, you know. So, but that was David. David had that persona about him that he made compelling viewing. You know, you never quite sure, knew what he was going to do next. Was he going to throw a microphone up in the air or fall over backwards or, you know, or do a press up or do a backflip? You know, he has that sort of unpredictable personality, you know.
Looking for love, and it's all here with the strength of a new day. Got the
David drank anyway, you know, and you drank before you went on stage. I mean, like in those days, most of us did. We have a drink because you're going out to create a party atmosphere with thousands of people. You want to fill in that mood yourself, you know.
What happened with David Byron and URIAH HEEP afterwards?
Eventually, his drinking did become a very big problem. And then a few months later, we were doing a show in Spain and we decided that we'd have to finish touring with David. Eventually, he died of alcohol. Eventually.
When did you hear that news?
That was in mid-80s, and I was actually out on the road at the time when somebody informed me of it, you know. It was a very sad time, you know. I was desperately sad about it, you know, because he was, you know, deep down he was a good friend, you know. But, it, you know, it's like all these people that have these problems, you know, the only way they can cure it is if they want to do it themselves. You can spend hours talking to someone. Trying to convince them otherwise, but you know, really it's got to be them that makes the decision.